Spirit.
Amen.
Grace and peace of the risen Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Today's responsorial psalm, we give praise to the Lord, whose love is eternal. The times we have ignored God's love in the world, let us ask for mercy and forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of God, Christ. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will open the gates to the kingdom of heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us give glory and praise to God in song. Pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Thank you.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to Shebna, master of the palace, I will thrust you from your office and pull you down from your station. On that day, I will summon my servant Eliakim, son of Hilkiah. I will clothe him with your robe and gird him with your sash and give over to him your authority. He shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. I will place the key of the house of David on Eliakim's shoulder. When he opens, no one shall shut. When he shuts, no one shall open. I will fix him like a peg in a sure spot to be a place of honor for his family. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God! How inscrutable are his judgments, and how unsearchable his ways! For who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor, or who has given the Lord anything that he may be repaid? For from him and through him and for him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Disciples, who do people say that the Son of Man is? They replied, some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. He said to them, but who do you say that I am? Simon Peter said in reply, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Jesus said to him in reply, blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah. For flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall never prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound on in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The Ockham is made master of the palace by the Lord in today's reading from Isaiah after Shebna is rebuked from that position. The House of the Forest of Lebanon was a prestigious building established by King Solomon in Jerusalem, in which a great amount of cedar wood from Lebanon was used for pillars and beams of the majestic castle. Eliakim was a man who sought to do what is right and just and throughout his life, and so God made him the master of the palace. On the other hand, Shebna was a wicked man who, according to Jewish historians, conspired with Assyria to attack Jerusalem. Eliakim is referred to in both the second book of Kings and Isaiah and is mentioned 9 times in Scripture. And now he succeeds Shebna in holding the key to the royal house of David. What he opens, no one can shut. What he shuts, no one can open. Eliakim means whom God will raise up, or the resurrection of God, both referring to the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Psalm 138 tonight states, Lord, your love is eternal. Do not forsake the work of your hands. Do not abandon us, Lord. May your love and mercy be with us always. You are aware of our human condition. We constantly need your help and guidance. Without you, we can do nothing. Let your mercy be upon us, Lord, as we place our trust in you now and always. How deep are the riches and the wisdom and the knowledge of God? This question is asked in today's reading from Romans, and the answer is simply beyond human understanding. We as human beings can only tap into the tip of the iceberg to grasp God's wisdom. He is the creator of the heavens and the earth. The Lord is all-knowing, all-loving, all-merciful, and yes, all-just. The Lord simply knows everything because he is the creator of all knowledge and wisdom. Before we were in the womb, he knew us. The Lord's love for each one of us is far more than we can ever imagine, because his love is eternal. The Lord simply knows everything. Mathematics, science, history, engineering, all things medical, theology, imagine that. Simply everything. And the Lord gives us our minds to discover and utilize the gifts and talents that we've been given to build up the kingdom of God. God, as we know, is the greatest architect of all time. Look at the beauty of the mountains around us, or the immensity of the seas, powerful, glorious, and beautiful. And God's greatest creation is every one of us, created in his image, to know him, to love him, and to serve him in this life, so we can give glory and praise to him in the next. As the song says, our God is an awesome God, creator of wisdom and knowledge and all that is good. And he wants all of us to be with him in paradise. May we give glory and praise to the Lord forever. The Lord has gathered with the disciples in today's gospel and asked them, who do people say that I am? A few speculated on the behalf of the people, but Simon Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit and fire, tells Jesus in front of the others, you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. And the Lord tells Peter, only the Heavenly Father could tell him this. The Lord knows the weaknesses of Peter, how he denied him three times during his passion, how he'd become fearful as he walked towards Jesus on the sea. And yet Jesus knew Peter's heart. He knew that Peter loved him, and the power of the resurrection transformed his heart forever. The man that proclaimed, you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God, is the heart of Peter that Jesus knew, the heart that the Lord wanted to first lead the church. The Lord calls Peter rock, and upon this rock he will build his church, and the gates of the netherworld will not prevail against it. Just as Eliakim, the righteous man, was given the key to the master palace in Jerusalem, Peter, in a much more powerful way, is given the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you declare bound on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever you declare loosed on earth shall be loosed in heaven. The Lord knew Peter's heart, that heart that could love and lead the church. The Lord knows our hearts, the tremendous ability we have to love, to forgive, to contemplate the beauty of God, and to bring the gospel to everyone that we encounter in our lives. May we be the best version of ourselves, entrusting God with all of our hearts and being Christ to the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world. Trusting the depths of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God, let us offer our needs and petitions.
We pray for pastoral leaders. May they never fail to be agents of God's mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for elected officials. May they govern with fairness and respect. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our country and all who call it home. May we be a people who seek justice for the oppressed and forgotten. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for students, teachers, coaches, and parents who feel the intensity of the school calendar. May they find times of silence to hear God's voice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an abiding respect for God's gift of human life. May we treasure the lives of all people, in particular those who live on the margins of society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who will celebrate the season of creation during the month of September. May our prayers be joined with others all over the world in the fervent hope that both our prayers and our actions might serve to repair and restore the world God has entrusted to us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our local community. May we expand our understanding of the kingdom of God and reach beyond our walls to help people most in need of God's love and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have died. May they rest in the peace of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the intentions of Trace and Hopkins, for which our Mass is offered. May all we hope for give glory to God by serving the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us pray. Shepherding God, through your Son Jesus, you assure us of a home in the kingdom of heaven. Receive our prayers, that by following his example, we might spread love and hope to all we meet. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the mighty Father. Lord, again, for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once for all. Bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. Gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of fame. Therefore, Lord, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognize the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Helena and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession and presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Austin Anthony, our Bishop, the order bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, to whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
families that are watching this Mass. Be assured of our prayers for you and pray for us, that all of us grow in holiness and love the Lord every day of our lives, so that one day soon we're giving the Lord glory and praise forever in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
A few announcements. Join us for our parish picnic at noon tomorrow. If you're planning on coming to the picnic later, we will have food saved downstairs in the kitchen for you. Last chance to purchase pig raffle tickets after Mass in the gathering space today or tomorrow at the parish picnic. Funds will go to support our youth attending the National Catholic Youth Convention. Drawing will be around 12:45 tomorrow afternoon. If you're in the hospital or know somebody who's in the hospital and like to receive communion, please contact the parish office, as St. Peter's will no longer disclose the information. Thank you to everyone who had their photos taken for the directory. If you missed out on the session and would still like to be part of it, you can submit a Head and Shoulders digital image and $20, and your photo will be added to a section of the other photos. You will also receive a hard copy of the directory. Please note that photos cannot be professional photos without a release and must be submitted to Allison or the office by August 29th. You can contact the office if you need help submitting a photo or would like Allison to take one. Also, immediately after Mass, we're setting up the tents for tomorrow's parish picnic, and we could use some help from some husky men. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.